not only I will blow my breath in them, but I will make them to come back to life. I'm gonna bring them back to life.
My God.
You ever see someone alive but still dead?
My God.
Or they got breath still there, but they still dead?
My God.
He said, I'm blowing my breath in them, and I'm gonna cause them to live again. To live again. And I will, my God. Someone better hear God today. And I will attach muscles, connect their bones together. I will structure them back to their rightful. So what they can do, that they can see my glory, that they will praise me because of my goodness and my mercy.
Hallelujah.
Some of you to know tonight, God said, in spite of how you appear to be dry, and some things are hopeless around you, God's about to do this just for his glory. He's about to bring a miracle just for his glory. He's about to turn things around just for his glory. Someone say, but the glory, Lord. Two things, and this will stood out to me as I start to more and more take this very, very scripture in. Two spiritual acts which will protect you and I from spiritual death. These are two. Now, hallelujah. You need to know that you will be protected from spiritual death if you allow God to breathe over you. Hallelujah.
Yes. Hallelujah.
You need the bread of life.
Yeah, you need the
Holy Ghost. I share that.
Yeah.
You need the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. There's another thing what you need. A prophetic word.
Yeah.
A prophetic word will change your season forever.
Yeah.
A prophetic word is the voice of God manifested through the prophet.
My
now,
God.
In the name of those two things, will cause you to be awakened from your dead places.
My God.
They took a prophetic word over my life when I was on the road of hell and just heading on that downward road. I was just, my God, normally grown up in church, in the midst of the formality, to come back. You know, we just said used to the church flow. Someone said church flow.
Church flow.
You gotta go to church when your mommy say go and all of that. You hear a word, you have level of conviction.
Yeah.
But there was a place where we have not surrendered totally to God.
Yes.
So the Lord God allowed a prophetic word to come my way. And after he sent the prophetic word, he released his bread upon me. I felt the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
I was immersed in the glory of God. What was dead, start to live again.
Yes.
If you need it, you need it.
You need it, you need it.
You need the breath of God.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
And you need the prophetic word of God.
Yes.
And when I start looking at the breath of God, I say, God, the Bible said how the Lord told Ezekiel to prophesy to the winds. And he said, speak then, say what you want to see, come forward. Speak to the house of Israel. Tell them what I'm about to do. And everything that Ezekiel said was what he was already told to say. God said, tell him I'm going to let the breath and the breath to come. Hallelujah, the wind is going to blow. God said, nature will have a part on your resurrection. Nature will have a part on you waking up from that dead. Nature, the wind, he used it by his power. And he manifests himself in the midst of a dry, dry house. So I tell you, neighbor, God is able to wake you up.
God is able to wake you
and
up.
And so, my God, you need to understand, hallelujah, glory to God, verse 11 said, and he said, son of man, these bones are the house of Israel. After he prophesied and these bones start finding their bone, the neck bone connected, hallelujah, hallelujah, the head bone connected, hallelujah, the leg bone connected, the thigh,